Rajneesh. Okay. Any so all participants are requested to once again put their questions or queries onto the chat box, and we will ask the speakers to have a look at that and maybe come back later on towards the end in person to answer these things. Okay. So, Mehreen, you can go on to the next session. So, next session you can introduce.
So the next session, it's on fecal sludge management and decentralized wastewater management. Over here, we'll start with the first presentation, which is by Mr. Prasanta Mahapatra, which is the Director of Water Corporation Odisha. It's a more of an institutional presentation. So over to you, sir. Can somebody unmute him, please? Or
Prashanta ji, I'm sorry. I realize that you had to. I hope you're still around. You had to go for a meeting.
Yeah, yeah. Can you see? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yes, yes, we are.
Sir.
I don't know.
Good afternoon to all of you. Good afternoon, and thank you, Dr. Rohila, for giving me this unique opportunity to speak all of you here. And it is really my pleasure to address all of you. And I am really thankful, Dr. Rohila, that with our cooperation for last 3 years and 3 and 4 years, we have come so far. And here I will be talking about our impressions, what we did in the last 4 years with cooperation with CSE. Next slide, please. Elisa Patnaik has already summarized our achievement, what we did in Odisha in FSSM. We started, in this slide, this is the kind of summarization of what we have done. In 2015, we took the opportunity of Amrut program, and we are the first state to opt for fecal sludge management instead of sewerage management. 2016, we looked after, because there was nothing in the country, hardly only one plant in Devanahalli. So we addressed the technology, what needs to be done in addressing the fecal sludge management, how do you treat that? So we developed in-house some technology and prepared a DPR. In fact, we sent that DPR to IIT Kharagpur for vetting to gain some confidence that the technology that we are going to adopt really works. 2017, we bought a lot of successful vehicles for septic transportation. The photo on the top, you can see the new vehicle we bought. 86 vehicles provided to 57 ULBs. Then we developed the state sanitation, urban sanitation policy, then the strategy. Then 17-18, we started constructing the fecal sludge treatment plants. 10 plants are already operationalized in 2018 October itself. Then we have been constructing fecal sludge treatment plants to saturate all our 114 urban local bodies. 2020, as you can see in the bottom photo, we engaged women self-help groups in the operation and maintenance of the fecal sludge treatment plants. So we have sort of, in the words of Secretary Mohua, we have de-technologized the FSTP so that it becomes so simple that even women self-help group can operate the plants. And in this process, this is not the journey of Odisha government alone. So we have E&Y, we have CSE, and we have many other experts who are with us. Next slide, please. So what we learned from CSE. In my chance meeting with Dr. Rohila in 2017, in FSM4 at Chennai, I requested him that since this is a new sector and hardly there are any training providers who have the background or who have the knowledge, and with the competency of CSE, why not they help the government of Odisha in the capacity development of our engineers and the municipal functionaries. In fact, we had some 60 new engineers. They were inducted into the government in the urban development department. So it was a challenge for us to train them, to capacitate them. And the new things were coming up, like the sit flow diagrams, and how do you design, suppose a person, one or two can design, but how to train all these persons, how do you sensitize them? The entire value chain of fecal sludge management was not well known to, you know, in the entire country also. So we were all, you know, searching for solutions. And thankfully, Dr. Rohila agreed. And thanks to our state government, then we got CSE's training under Amrut. So we learned all about those modules, the seed flow diagrams. And as I was listening to many presentations here, it has tremendously, you know, not only in India and, you know, outside India also, it is such a powerful tool. And our engineers and our municipal functionaries, they are really happy. They really were so pleased. I am personally so pleased that we could and all could learn this seed flow diagram so easily from the expertise available with CSE. Then the septic treatment, the, you know, even in one of the sessions when I was present, they were explaining how to design, and it was such an interactive session, calculating capacity, sizing, and for me also it was, you know, many lessons learned. And also, Marin Madam, you also took some classes, urban design, and so many, you know, I can't remember so many things. So it has been, you know, so much of learning. It is difficult to pinpoint, you know, in person, but wonderful experience learning from all the expertise that is available with you. Next slide, please. Then what we learned there at New Delhi or at the NIMLI Institute, so it helped our people back in the state in the implementation of the entire program. I'm very happy also that even our E&Y experts, they were also, they took training in CSE. So with the knowledge that we gathered, it was, in fact, to talk about FSSM, in today's world, everybody will talk about FSSM because they have now implemented and they have gone through the whole journey. And it is because of you, CSE, Dr. Rohila, you gave the opportunity to us. So our engineers now, they have become very street smart. And the municipality level also, learning a little bit on urban governance and focus on project implementation and sensitization of all the aspects of the value chain that made us really worthy. And with that capacity, that enabled us to, you know, better implement our projects. That is why with the able guidance of our principal secretary, Odisha is marching ahead, you know, in the implementation of fecal sludge management in all the, you know, towns and cities of Odisha. Next slide, please. Already, I do not know whether our participants, they know it or not. Odisha government has already signed an MOU with CSE for, you know, urban water sensitive urban design. So that will help the cities in all the 114 urban local bodies. It will help us in managing the urban floods. And maybe if we start, you know, working together, there will be other challenges also, challenges related to water pollution, challenges related to, you know, drawdown or scarcity of groundwater, though this is a coastal area, it's a coastal state. We will expect a lot of rainfall, but despite the adequate number of lot of rainfall, also there are many cities which are water scarce. So when you adopt the design, the other day I was listening to Dr. Rohila's water sensitive urban design. So it is a lot of challenge. There is a lot of understanding. There is a lot of clarity that needs to be addressed. So it will be in the coming months, it will be challenging both for CSE and also for us, you know, to merge together and march together in the water sensitive design area. So with this, I thank you all for listening to me. Thank you, Dr. Rohila. Thank you, CS.
Thanks, Prashantaji. I just forgot. I was aware that you had some meeting you had to go, but I hope it is not disrupting too much. If there are any questions from any participants to Prashantaji, please pose there. Thank you, Prashantaji, for your kind words, and we look forward to a long journey. And actually, we enjoy that if there are more challenges and if Odisha offers us those challenges where we can be part of a solution to those challenges, I would say. So that would be interesting to see. You know, otherwise, easy job done is not job done for us. So thank you very much, Mansi.
Thank you for your kind words.
So we have completed, I think, Marine. We are into the second theme.
Thank you.
Thanks, Prashantaji, once again. Raghu, yes.
So our next presenter is Raghu Soma. He's the environmental engineer at Silsila Municipality. He attended a couple of trainings related to city sanitation plan, fecal sludge management. And his topic of presentation is implementation of fecal sludge management in Silsila City. So over to you, Raghu. We are
audible? Time.
Yeah, loud and clear.
Yeah, am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Actually, being an alumna and being a speaker at today's workshop, it's a really pleasure to me. And Sirsila is a second grade municipality of Telangana state, 75,640 population based on the 2011 census. But the containments are around 16,000. In that, 40% of containments are single pit, twin pit, semi-permeable walls, which is connected to open drain. And then remaining 60% of the containments are fully lined and sealed septic tanks, which are also connected to open drain. Silsila doesn't have a sewer network. So I attended the trainings, a couple of trainings in conducted by the CAC and JZ on city sanitation plan at Hyderabad. I attended those, which we have got to attend that training programs. Coming to the presentation, this is our plant. This is the layout. Next slide, please. Yeah, project cost is 1.6 crore, which is got from 14 FC funds. So project time is 12 months and implementation agency pre the group. Based on the ship flow diagram, we decided to construct the fecal sludge treatment plant to save disposal of the fecal and decreasing the pollution load to the environment. So next slide, please. These are the whatever the actually our FSTP based on purely nature music solutions. We have used the models in our FSTP. There is a screening chamber to screen the solids from raw FS, and the stabilization reactor is there, and the unplanted sludge drying beds are there. So after that, indicated AVR with filter chambers are there. The planted gravel filter is there, and collection tank and sand and carbon filter is there. Finally, polishing pond is there. So these are the modules of our FSTP. Through that, we are till now receiving almost 180 loads till now. So per day is average is 2 loads. Actually, we have only 5 licensed operators are here. So those are earlier, actually, those are whenever they empty the septic tanks, they disposed in an open ground illegally. So now actually they are very happy to have a FSTP to dispose in a safe manner. Next slide, please. These are the complete flow process of the fecal sludge treatment plant. You all are aware about this. Next slide, please. Actually, impact and outcome, whenever we're talking about impact and outcome, there is a lot of change before intervention, before the FSTP and after the FSTP. So the illegal disposing of fecal sludge has been stopped, and now the farmers are knowing the importance of the manure. They are really asking us to buy the natural fertilizer to utilize it in their fields. And moreover, mango farmers are mostly demand from them. So these are the impacts. And our future plan is mostly now the O&M is taken care about these blue water company for 2 years. After these 2 years, we are involving the self-help group women to maintain the pre-cultured treatment plant and as well as emptying service for their livelihood purpose. So we have a proposal to procure a vacuum truck through their TLF fund and in future the self-help group women will engage in the sanitation sector. Mostly I attended the trainings conducted by the CSC. So Shikku diagram I attended and CSP trainings at Hyderabad in 2015-16-17 and the final training also I attended. So really whatever I acquired the knowledge, through that I prepared a DPR, a draft DPR for our fecal sludge treatment plant. Through that whatever we find the gaps, so design a FSTP with the partner of CDD and other freezer group. So now it's commissioned last year. We are still waiting the lab reports. This is my presentation, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Raghu, for an interesting presentation, and you are one of our brightest alumni. You know, we have had a long association.
Yeah, thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
And today to have you as a speaker is my privilege, you know.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
So, yes, Rajneesh, do you have any question to anybody till now? Rajneesh, Suparno, anybody? Any not of exactly. The jury members?
I think not exactly the question, but I think we have taken a lot of time to absorb the information which is coming to us. So, okay. And very interesting journey people are putting up, and I think the scales are very varied and a lot of interesting things for as a jury member also to learn from.
Yeah. You have a difficult job. Yeah.
Yeah, it's too much of information now to be handled within those, and people have really put a good effort to bring up whatever is the best in on the field and from the learning which they got from CA.
They are the real champions. We are just the receiving end. So looking forward to the next presentation. Maureen, please take over.
It's now we from Silsila down south, we go back to Bangladesh. So it's Tariqul Islam, who attended our international training on tools and approaches for citywide water and sanitation management. He's the senior technical manager at the NGO Forum for Public Health. So over to you, Tariq.
Hi, very good afternoon. So this is Tariqul. I am working with NGO Forum for Public Health. And this is a national service delivery organization. As working with water sanitation and hygiene, environmental dedicated to contribute the improvement of public health situation since 1982. Okay. So now I am presenting initiative of citywide fecal sludge management in city corporation area of Bangladesh. Okay. So ma'am, next slide, please.
Okay.
So we are currently implementing a project. The title of the project, Resilient, Inclusive, and Innovative Cities in Bangladesh. So the project has implementing since July 2018, and the project will be continue up to 2023. So the major focus of this project is WASH, fecal sludge management, disaster risk reduction, yield capacity development, etc. So in terms of fecal sludge management, the major objectives to develop a functional fecal sludge management system, ensuring livelihood opportunity while ensuring disposal and treatment of the fecal sludge for the target groups. So the project has implementing jointly with Moymoyingsingh City Corporation, and the funded from the project from Australian Aid and Oxfam Bangladesh. So madam, next slide, please.
Yes.
So CAC contribution in knowledge development. So earlier I have ma'am already mentioned I have received a training on tools and approaches for citywide water and sanitation management system in 2018. So from this training, most relevant component, I have learned lots of decentralized wastewater treatment system, sheet flow diagram, and city sanitation plan also. So major achievement from this training, I have learned a lot of things, especially in the designing and technological knowledge, and enhance the skill on citywide sanitation management project. Also, networking with other professionals and FSM expert. So next slide, please. So now we can share the impact of implemented project. So basically this project have started since 2018, focusing the fecal sludge management. So under this project, we have initiated few activities, which is basically directly and indirectly impacted. So at the beginning, we have conducted the fecal sludge management system baseline study and characterization of the fecal sludge. This study is jointly with the Bangladesh Agricultural University, Moymunshing. Besides, we have analysis the containment system and preparation the sheet flow diagram, assessment of collection transportation system also. And compiling this information, we have prepared design and finally construct the fecal sludge management treatment plan. Besides, we have preparation operational guideline, which is which will guide it for the operation and everything in terms of fecal sludge management system. Besides, we have conducted a environmental impact assessment. So next slide, please.
Sorry.
No, we have a future plan for this in terms of fecal sludge management. So we have a plan to utilize knowledge in upcoming project as well as ongoing project, and planning to building organizational colleagues capacity building, especially in fecal sludge management. Besides, we have a plan to develop a citywide sanitation plan in other city corporation area. So it also mentioned that we have already taken few initiatives to prepare the sheet flow diagram in the other city areas, as well as, you know, in Bangladesh, lots of project, especially in the Rohingya response. So we have already taken few initiative to prepare the sheet flow diagram in the Rohingya camp context also. So this is my short presentation, basically.
No, so, it's short and precise. Thanks a lot, Tariku.
Okay.
Thank you very much. So now our next presenter is from Bangladesh. One of our most valuable partner, which is WaterAid Bangladesh, Dr. Abdul Al Moeed. He heads the policy and advocacy unit of WaterAid Bangladesh. It's an institutional presentation, the journey which CSC and WaterAid Bangladesh has gone in the area of fecal sludge and decentralized wastewater management. So I give the screen to Moeed so that he can deliberate his presentation. Over to you, Moeed.
Excellent. Thank you, my dear friends and colleagues. I hope you can see me, right?
Time you come with interesting presentation, Moeed. I should.
Excellent. So before starting, I mean, I'm showing you some of the puzzles. I mean, different shapes here. It's an octagonal. It's a pyramidal one. It's a, you know, some sort of parabolic puzzle. So these are the puzzles, and this is the regular puzzle actually. And these are solved, and some of the puzzles actually I keep it on my desk to play with my friends and my colleagues here. So what they do usually come here and they do it like this, whatever they do, like mess, like this, and they keep it on my desk to solve them. So my task is to solve those puzzles in a, you know, sometime when I have some time. So this is the puzzle solving presentation, I believe. And today I would like to present the ABCs of the, those puzzle solving elements of our partnership between CSC and WaterAid. I'm sure Maureen and Suresh will not give me a lot of time, but do you see my screen, first of all?
We can.
Okay, fantastic. So that's why I actually solve it here. I'm opening the solution here. This is the solution of the puzzle. And if I go to, unfold this puzzle one more time, so we will get four elements of the, whole puzzle, solving agent. The first one, let me go back to the 2009. WaterAid and the CSC, both the organizations are very much, strong in advocacy with their national government. And during 2009, because of our, initiation of our whole partnership, WaterAid Bangladesh at first sent a few of our colleagues to India, to CSC, to get the training, who are very much, professional on training. And they returned to Bangladesh with their expertise. I don't want to quote their name. They are very much famous architects in the country. But soon after that, we look back both the organizations, and we revealed that we need to understand our strengths and we need to create some opportunities accordingly. And the strength of the CSC is the training, and we want to expand it in Bangladesh. So we reversed the model immediately during 2009. So from India, CSC experts are invited to come to Bangladesh, and immediately, we could create more than 30 professionals at a time. And the time started with the dewars and rainwater harvesting. Yesterday, you already got a presentation on the rainwater harvesting, and today I would like to, present mostly on the dewars and FSM, how our journey started and where we are right at this moment. So let me focus on the strength of our individual organizations, and we signed an MOU and agreement and MOU and started working together immediately. At that time, the Millennium Development Goal, MDG era, and both the organizations are doing the advocacy with the national government, right? And we want to keep in mind that actually catalyst, what would be the appropriate changes for the SDG globally. So from national aspect, CSC's contribution, from India's aspect, and from Bangladesh aspect, WaterAid contribution connected to the SDGs alignment later on. So now coming to the, after the strength of the advocacy, what we would like to deliver. The second one is the research and capacity development. So we wanted to see a bigger picture here. So we wanted to have some research opportunity here. We want to establish here in Bangladesh, create this opportunity with the sector capacity development initiative. And that actually creates a bigger opportunity. And we paved that. And as I mentioned earlier, the DWAR was the first generation where we started soon, after 2010. It continued until 2015. But who doesn't love the flower? And we have created state-of-the-art example, evidences in some of the parts of the Bangladesh, like in Khulna. There are four models. I believe those are the state-of-the-art DWAR model. And one in Shakipur, which was actually the first generation DWAR. So you see, when I say that, it becomes the first generation, second generation, and that means it's the continuous evolvement of the research and improvement. That's what we did it together. And we build up a very strong professional network, 150 plus professionals since then. Oh, I'm very, excited to say this number. And I'm glad to see many of the alumni today here. Actually, the impact, greater impact of the seeding that we did in 2009. And these professionals are very important. Why? Because they are from the government, they are from the private sector, they are from the NGOs. And whenever they become the alumni, got the training, they go back to their institutions and apply their training, learning into their own field. And I can say a very good example here. In whoever visited Bangladesh, you know, the, from Gulshan 1 Avenue to 2 Avenue of this street is very posh area. And there are, you know, in 2018, I estimated that there were 22 buildings which were, you know, on the way to get green certificate. Some of them already got at that time, 5 out of 22. And out of 22, 18 of them were designed by somehow our alumni. This is the impact I am telling it here, very meticulously. I don't need any other thing. When I got this impact, that's the bigger picture we want to see, to create an ambient environment for Bangladesh, the country, the change that we really need in the coming days. We created, you know, some research and evidences, you know, some of the research papers are output, visible output. And we also evaluated our DWAR system in the coming days, you know, later on, and it worked very well. And not only that, CSE has its own DWAR manual, but in order to make it more robust, more global, so WaterAid UK, with the technical expertise through me, it has been channelized through me, of course, but I'm glad to let you know that, WaterAid UK has its global guideline, and definitely, you know, the knowledge that has been transferred from CSE to Bangladesh and to make it a global impact in the other country programs of the WaterAid, separate technical guidelines have been prepared by WaterAid UK. And we don't want to stop our research. We want to see the next generation research. And when we say that we treated the wastewater, can we do the recharge on this? Of course, don't worry at this moment. We will not do it until we get a lot of very good evidence. But we started the research with the University of Dhaka. The potential is very, 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 you know, positive right at this moment. But I can say you right at this moment, they are, you know, as good as the quality of irrigation. So I can have this evidence, but in order to do a little bit, you know, more as research quality, we need to do a further stage. We are taking this forward. So this is the story of the wastewater that we took it for, you know, since 2009, and we are contributing now for the SDG 6 achievement together. Further, you know, research and collaborative efforts that come from here in Bangladesh, we were very much confident on the circular economical aspect, cradle to grave concept, and accordingly, the state of the art co-composting or FSM technology, we, you know, implemented since 2014. And we shared our knowledge also with CSE, and very honestly, you know, throw out the knowledge and expertise from their end and from our practical implementation, it created a, such a strong bond. Even physical glue is not stronger than this bond, I am sure of that. So the solid waste management, pickup plus management, and we started the sector capacity development on FSSM. This is the first word. India is using mostly on septage management. I could still remember I had the discussion with Suresh, and we wanted the fecal sludge management. So we combine it together and made this FSSM. We started this journey since 2015, and the training that we organized in Dhaka or bigger Dhaka have contributed a lot. And today I can see a lot of alumni from there also. And of course, the training materials of the CSCs are very much, you know, influential and very much helpful in that journey. And we have created more than 100 professionals plus professionals throughout this training period from 2015 to 2017. Of course, the ingredients are SFD, as many of you know, and sanitation safety plan. Those are the ingredients and the parts and parcel of the whole training package. And we have created some of the technical evidences, you know, also, which are exemplified in the global scale. I would like to go to the third point now. Throughout this journey until 2017, we have developed some expertise. And this expertise wanted to reflect on, again, as an agent of advocacy further, we want to see the bigger picture. So both the organizations now have, you know, this expertise on this waste management and fecal sludge management, circular economy, sanitation safety planning, and integrated solid waste management. And most importantly, how we would like to implement this SFD, street flow diagram, in a future SFD as a monitoring tool. And that's what we are actually convening it together. These 100 plus professionals are the catalyst. That's what we believe, particularly after that 2017 journey. And these expertise together, what I really believe is not the unidirectional, it's the both directional, from India to Bangladesh and from Bangladesh to India. And I'm sure of that we will do it in the coming days. The last element, you cannot see it, it's the invisible one. Even at the left bottom side, you can see that it's invisible, but you can see money and partnership. I mean, it's an open channel. We don't have any sort of, you know, formal MOU or agreement now since 2017.
Well, but we left.
Last minute, right? The strategic partnership lead us to such a pinnacle of this journey. We developed such model, and as evidence, we have developed 9 SFDs, health SFD help desk, of course, some of other innovation, but most importantly, to influence the national government from each country to contribute for the SSM and other topics also. And this will definitely lead us to achieve the SDG 6.2 goal. So those who have still confusion on what is this ABC, I am solving it for the ABC, and the puzzle has been solved, you see. Thank you so much. It's well solved. Over to you, Marvin.
Thanks, Wade. Really impressive presentation. That's why we say we see WaterAid as a valuable partner. And now in India also, we are developing partnership ahead, scaling up. Thank you very much, Mohit. Always appreciate it.
Thank you so much, Suresh.
All right. So we go to the next presenter, Mr. Suraj. He's the Associate Director at IP Global. It is going to be an institutional presentation, Applied Learnings from CSC Training. So just a sec. I will do.
Okay. Can people restrict to 5-6 minutes because we have 3-4 presentations?
Okay. Yeah. So over to you, Suraj.
Hi. Good afternoon, everyone. It was a very wonderful session since the morning to understand and learn a very good experience of the state. So here, from IP perspective, I would be sharing 3 different learning that we have used and. Applied in some of the projects that we are working in India and other parts of the Southeast Asia. Next presentation. Yes. So the first story is about Andaman and Lakshadweep Island. This is a project that we are doing as part of NITI Aayog support. And then one of the solutions that we have been asked to derive is that what kind of a sustainable island resilient plan that we can come across in terms of both water and sanitation. So, of course, I will have a slide at the end of the day which summarize all the key takeaways from all these exercises that we have done. The picture that you see here, it is a kind of a contrast where we see a very good island, you know, beautiful sceneries. And also, if you go inside the islands, you also realize that there is a big issues in terms of waste management, both in terms of the liquid waste management, solid waste management. Water is a big challenge because salinities and the groundwater table, although it's pretty high, but it has high salinity content. So getting a fresh water is a challenge in the island. So the challenge here we had that how do we link all these problems and convert into a solution, not only to water as a standalone solution, not only the wastewater as a standalone solution, but linking all these together, of course, linking with also agriculture. I have come across recently an article of PhD that says that there is a way out here that if we link water, sanitation, and agriculture, I totally believe and agree to that. And this is how we have also tried and implement in both the islands, Andaman and Lakshadweep, that how all these problems can be connected together in terms of a solution. Next slide. So as part of the climate resilient infrastructure planning, the integrations component, if we talk about, we look into both centralized and decentralized approach of wastewater solutions, but not just restricting ourselves to that, but also linking into the reuse model of the co-compostings from the solid waste part. So what are we trying to achieve here? That we not only looking into wastewater solutions of the entire islands, but also dewatered for the large premises of commercials and the schools and these bigger premises where these dewatered can be installed. We need to understand here that wastewater management is not just a challenge for the environment as a macro element, but also it affects the day-to-day life of the islanders there. If you the dugvale that you see, the dugvale that you have in the island is the only source of water, and the contamination is getting in from these toilets and untreated waste getting into the groundwater, polluting the limited amount of aquifer that you have. So, and again, how do you handle the waste? You cannot have incineration plant with a kind of a population that we are looking into 10,000 or 20,000 of populations. You have to find an alternative. So what was happening in these islands, like one of the islands in Lakshadweep, which is a mini Kauai with the 20,000 population, they were actually transporting the waste to Kochi, which is a near port here. So you understand the amount of challenges that differ from the mainland to the islands. The waste becomes a problem, because the footprint, the land footprint is very limited here. Similarly, so as I said, the dewatering has been looked into in a wider aspect, not only at the bigger premises of the residential area, but also for the institutional premises. So what kind of application that we have got for here from the training the team members has got it. So one of the training that it was the city-wide water and sanitation management approach that has my 4 to 5 team members have get into it, and they understand the essence and the meaning of the green infrastructures. How do we plan the whole water planning and then ODF plus plus and how do we link all these water sanitations and other components together. So interestingly, one of the green infrastructure component that our team member like Sakshi Gudara was part of it, and then just after that this workshop, we had a very combined meeting at our Delhi office, and then we share an ideas, and then we come up with an idea that why can't we have kind of a FSTP in a climatic challenging situation in Andaman or Lakshadweep, which is LEED or GRIHA certified. So looking into that kind of aspect that we have tried and figured out in both the islands, where we say that, we have come up with a detailed project report and the whole planning that we have developed. And we say that the island, the first time, in fact, is these projects get implemented, which NITI Aayog is looking after, and they are very aggressive in terms of implementation. These FSTPs will have 4 to 5 green GRIHA ratings in terms of the whole sustainability pictures and all. So just to give you a glimpse of not just looking into the powers and the reuse of the construction material, but also not looking into the borewells for the day-to-day maintenance of the FSTPs, but largely relying on the rainwater harvesting and adhering to the sustainability needs of the island. Next slide, please. So this is the second story here. This is, we recently did a project, it was GGI funded in Cambodia, in Siam Reap. And it was largely to understand the need of FSM, need of sanitation, efficient sanitation solutions in this city. So just to give you a context here, the background here, the Siam Reap is a place where you have this Angkor Wat temple, the world's largest Hindu temple. And this city is give you contribute to 15% GDPs of the entire Cambodia's economy. So huge influx in terms of the tourist population that you get in. You see the picture down here that large number of crowd in the cities, and eventually we realized that 50% of the 50% of the users group in the cities is the tourist which is coming to these towns. So a very contrasting situation where, hello?
Yeah, please go ahead, Suraj.
Yeah. So very contrasting situation here where you have huge amount of tourist influx coming in the cities. Then how do you understand the design and the needs of the cities? And this is where the one of the signature tool of CEC, the SFT, has been used to understand that how the whole shit flow diagram, how this whole process is flowing, not just from the sewerage or from the septic tank, but also from the other source of the containment. And what kind of a green and red that we see here in terms of the action areas. So very interesting and very impressive tool. Although we have tried and customized some of these tools, but this has been a very helpful to understand that what are the key areas in Siam Reap that we need to take into account in terms of sanitation intervention. Next slide, please. Now, the two projects that I talked about, it was about the more of a planning and then whole designing and the approach and the solution that we, as a team that we have brought. This third and the last story is about Rajasthan.
I think Suraj, hello?
Suraj, can you unmute yourself? I think by mistake.
Yes. Yeah, please. No issues. I hope you were able to hear all that I said before this slide.
Just a very small lag only. Just please go ahead.
Okay. So we talked about the kind of planning and approach that we have developed in a couple of projects, both in Andaman and Siam Reap, and there are more to it. But this is a project that we have come across in terms of a construction implementation, and I would say the complete project cycle support from planning, designing, supervision, construction monitoring, and the whole of it. Of course, there was setback also initially because we started in 2016, and there were some failed solutions that was not economical or feasible in terms of sewer solutions or non-sewer solutions. So the success story in Rajasthan is a mix of it. It is not just only in terms of infrastructure. It is in terms of embedded solutions in the urban sanitation framework of the municipalities, and also the kind of strategic and then kind of a measure that state has to look into it. So what we did that we look into the holistic picture of the sanitation solutions. Of course, infrastructure is one prime area. So we developed the three pilot FSCPs, the first kind of FSCPs in Rajasthan that we have developed. Now all of three of them are operational. You see the picture here in the slide, which is before and after situations. So most of these trucks were coming in and they were desludging it and dumping in the open ground. You see the unsafe practice of desludging operations from the desludging operators, private operators. Now there's a shift to the whole situation in Rajasthan, especially in the three areas where you have a very good functional FSCPs and you have an entire SOP standard operating procedures in place in Rajasthan. And as I said, that not just infrastructure, but also these, we have develop a SSM ordinance, sanitation ordinance at the town level, which has been approved from the municipal board. So this includes that, set of kind of a resolution that the ULB has to look into in terms of institutional regulatory reforms, licensing, ensuring that, all the truck operators adhere to it and then they follow the guidelines of dumping to the diesel, to the treatment plant and other set of the requirements. So, and then what do we see here that not just in terms of solutions, a fixed solution, but we have to look into the progressive realization of the solution. So we set up a sanitation committee in the town. And then
1 minute left.
Couple of last slides. So then we have given a control to the committees that they take a decision for all the future actions in that regard. So even the consultant and the contractors, the operators, comes into the exit phase. We have a strong and solid plan in place to make this entire solution sustainable in the long run. Next slide.
Can you just summarize in last try? Okay, what you can relate it with the learnings from the training because we have four presentations more to go.
Next slide. That's about the CSU training. So so as I said that some of my team members have participated in the trainings and I have specifically asked them to create this table so that the learning can be clearly communicated here. So three trainings from CSC, we are very thankful to all of them. And then so one is about the tools and approaches that we talked about for water and sanitation management. And this is how we learned that how efficiently we can plan our islands level design and planning for the sanitation approaches, our integrated approaches that I talked about. And not just sanitation as a standalone solution, but looking into the sustainable solution for the water also, for all the rainwater harvesting tools and all the green infrastructure techniques that CSC training has given to the participants. They have been largely used to customize the infrastructure solution in terms of a green solution here. Second is a sanitation safety planning. Then again, looking into this whole SFD using as part of the Siam Reap solutions and other parts of the analysis also, SFD is a signature tool that we always use. Understanding the case studies and the senses, best practices has also been really helpful to understand that what are the key takeaways probably in that project context we can use it here. Overall, there are more to it, although we have been asked to summarize in 5 slides. So I, as a organization, IT Global, is very thankful to CSEs to give us this opportunity to, you know, present and share the kind of experiences that we had. And also, more than that, you know, I think like more than 10 to 15 team members have been fortunate enough to take the, you know, participations in the lot of other trainings also that TSC has organized. And very, very helpful experience. I must say, it is a one platform that has given a holistic picture of looking into sanitation, waters, and other things. So, yeah, very helpful in totality.
Thank you, Suraj. Thank you. Excellent presentation. Thank you. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you.
So, we do have a very tight walk now, Marin, because we have a couple of presentations. Yes. And is the next speaker ready?
Yes.
Yeah.
S.K. Gupta ji, he's the General Manager, Gomti Pollution Control Unit, Uttar Pradesh Jal Nigam. An institutional partnership because CSE has an MOU with the Directorate of local bodies, UP. We have a PSU and a TSU unit set in UP with regard to fecal sludge management. So Gupta ji, you are over to you, 6 minutes.
Okay, thank you. Myself, SK Gupta, and I am looking after the FSSM project of UP with the guidance of Amrit Directorate. Our UP Jal Nigam is responsible for the water supply and sewerage project of Uttar Pradesh, and we are also the implementing agency of Amrit towns. And in UP, total number of ULBs are 562. Out of that, we are considering under Amrit are 60s, and out of that, 57 are considered under FSTP program. For these FSTP plants, CSC has given the support to UP Jal Nigam. They have sent 60 officials under different program within the country and outside the country. They have given 5 technical training, 2 regional workshop, and 3 numbers national exposure visits and 3 international exposure visits. By these, Jal Nigam people learned the how to implement the FSTP plants country as well as outside the state. We have developed one plant in Unnao, and it is giving very good results as decided by the Ministry of Environmental and Forest. And results of BOD is less than 10. It is very good, but TSS is somewhat exceeding the limits. For that, we are considering how to reduce that. Now, out of 31 FSTP plants, we have proposed 7 technologies. And with the help of CSR, we will monitor the different technologies and decide which is the best suited solution for FSTP plants. Suggestion for the training is that if CSC should every month 4 engineers training outside the state or outside the country so that we can develop footprint for the next generation.
What was your international experience, sir? Because you have been part of our international exposure visit. You want to share?
We have to the Madhya and we seen 7 to 8 places where FST plant were constructed and
very good.
Very good.
So,
okay, thank you very much.
Thank you,
Gupta ji, for a very encouraging response and coverage of UP's experiences. And we are privileged to assist Department of Urban Development. And with your support, we would be able to take up further work. So, Mehreen, please.
Yeah. So, our next presentation is from NMCG National Mission Clean Ganga, Mr. Rajat Gupta and Nidhi Dwivedi. So, the presentation is again on the institutional level with regard to the fecal sludge management. So over to you.
Thanks, Mary. Thanks, Dr. Rohila. Can you hear me?
Yes, loud and clear.
Right. So good afternoon all. One thing is that Namami Gange, the program which is being executed by National Mission for Clean Ganga, it is primarily from the perspective of rejuvenation of River Ganga. Can we move on to the next slide?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And when we talk of River Ganga, it's basically the River Ganga basin that we are looking at. The River Ganga, which is nearly 2,500 odd kilometers. And it contains 11 states and 5 states mainly on the River Ganga main stem itself. And the catchment area is nearly 8 lakh square kilometers. Can you move on to the next step, please? And this covers nearly 26% of India's total land mass and 47% population that resides in Ganga basin. And nearly there are 40 odd rivers or tributaries of River Ganga that we are looking at. It contributes nearly 28% of India's water resources. So this is about basically Ganga basin that we are looking at and we are working on to it and for the cleanliness or the rejuvenation of River Ganga. Next slide. And when we look at the rejuvenation or the cleaning part of River Ganga, the major polluters that we are looking at is municipal wastewater, industrial pollution, solid waste, and agro residues, etc., and some non-point sources. And when we look at municipal wastewater, right? So, and primarily for all of these factors, there are certain Namami Gange components that we have devised and we are working on to it. So can we move on to the next slide? So there are nearly 7 components that the Namami Gange program has conceptualized. It's the Nirmal Dhara, which is looking at the cleaning of the river. Aviral Dhara, it's ensuring the continuous flow into the river. And then we are looking at water quality monitoring, regularly the river water quality monitoring. And then certain aspects which connects the citizens to the river, that is development of riverfronts, ghats, crematoria, etc. And then there are certain aspects which are linked to the river rejuvenation, like afforestation, biodiversity conservation, and then going into policy, research, knowledge management, and certainly not the least, and one of the most important tasks is public participation. Because unless until public participation is there, we certainly cannot really look into for the Ganga rejuvenation or Ganga cleaning. So everyone needs to contribute in over here. Next slide, please. And in Nirmal Dhara, when we look at the pollution abatement aspect, what we are really looking at from the perspective of municipal sewage, creation of sewage infrastructure and sewage treatment plants in the towns, and then industrial pollution abatement, rural sanitation aspects, water quality monitoring, and solid waste management. But when we look at the municipal sewage or the sewerage infrastructure, so the Namami Gange program has been addressing primarily the municipal sewage that is being generated from the large towns. And NMCG has been advocating development of networks and preparation of conventional sewage treatment plants for the treatment of that sewage. But that particular aspect of that particular kind of a strategy was not adequate enough to really address the sewage from the smaller towns. The towns which are generating less than 2 MLD of sewage or 1 MLD of sewage, right? So it's not really economically viable to develop a network over there or even going in for interception and diversion kind of a systems and then going in for treatment or conventional STPs. And some of those towns even are heavily dependent upon the septic tanks or soak pits. So really don't have very continuous flow of wastewater even into the drains over there. And there's another problem of even in the bigger towns wherein we have developed the sewerage networks of the STP, there is a continuous development of new townships keeps coming in. And these townships are not really connected with the networks or the kind of sewage treatment plants that have been we have developed over there. So that kind of a wastewater is again generated and goes into the river. And that is where we need to have the a change in the strategy, and wherein we discussed with CSE, Dr. Rohila has been there with us for a lot of those such discussions, and wherein we came to a conclusion that yes, there is a need for inclusion of fecal sludge management also in the strategy. So next step is, so realizing that National Mission for Clean Ganga entered into an MOU with Central, the CSE, Center for Science and Environment, for providing technical assistance in mainstream fecal sludge and septage management in Ganga Basin. Although the agreement was executed on 14-9-2018, but the work really started even before that. And with CSE, we have been able to develop certain capacity, already around 35 officials from NMCG, State Mission for Clean Ganga, and state executing agencies have already been trained on fecal sludge management aspects from CSE. And the strategy modification that I was looking at, what we have come to know or what we have decided to move into is that we need to promote standalone FSTPs for the smaller towns, which are primarily depend upon septic tanks and soak pits. Right? And these kind of towns are really not economically viable or sustainable to be covered under interception diversion or network or conventional STP kind of a projects. And the second modification that was done was even in the STPs wherein we have already developed in the larger towns wherein we have developed larger STPs, we should have a provision for an FSTP. And if there is a possibility, then even a co-treatment or co-processing of the fecal sludge within the sewage treatment plant. And towards these initiatives, we, with the help of CSE, also took up a project in Chunar for development of a fecal sludge and septage treatment plant. It's a small town in UP, and wherein this study was undertaken by CSE, and the project was sanctioned, and the project is currently under implementation. In addition, in Bihar and West Bengal, certain projects have been taken up in large towns wherein the co-treatment or co-processing of the fecal sludge have already been taken into consideration and sanctioned. Fecal sludge management or co-treatment has also been largely used in Prayagraj during Kumbh, wherein a lot of wastewater is generated from the temporary toilets that have been constructed onto the banks of River Ganga. And in order to prevent the pollution of River Ganga, all that fecal sludge was taken to the existing sewage treatment plants for the treatment. Right? And similarly, this Kanpur also, we are promoting all this fecal sludge and its treatment in existing sewage treatment plants. Next slide, please. And even in the future course, what we are looking at is we continue to promote the fecal sludge management in Ganga Basin and also in the other river basins, right? Even beyond, going beyond the Ganga through NRCD or some other agencies. We are also looking at performance assessment of the ongoing projects for further improvements that needs to be taken up while sanctioning the new projects. And also learning from the experiences that we have in Odisha or other places, maybe through CSE, we need to learn all of these things. And we are going to utilize the same co-treatment even in Haridwar Kumbh 2021, because again, there's going to be a huge congregation of the public wherein this needs to be utilized. And we look forward to continue the capacity building or training exposure visits. Right. So this is in brief what we have been doing on fecal sludge management towards achieving our objective of Ganga rejuvenation. So that's in brief. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Rajat. Thank you very much. And we need to do more, actually.
Yeah.
So thank you very much, Rajat. All the best. I'll catch up with you separately, but we can now go to one of the target towns where this is also part of the Ganga Basin strategy where CSE is supporting. Marine.
Yeah. So So as in continuation to what Dr. Rohila mentioned, so this is we have a technical support unit for two of the cities of UP. One is Chunar, which Mr. Rajat Gupta mentioned in his presentation. The another one is Bijnor. And we have with us Mr. Durgeshwar Tripathi, who is the executive officer at Bijnor, who will be Bijnor Nagar Palika Parishad, who will be talking about the institutional presentation. So over to you, sir.
Hi. Sabko namaskar. Main Durgeshwar Tripathi. Dishasya Adhikari Nagar Palika Parishad Bijnor. Please show me.
The previous one, sir?
Yes. Main batana chahunga ki श्री आशीष नगर पालिका बिजनौर चार पांच सालों से जुड़ी हुई है और मैं यहाँ 2018 में कार्यरत हूँ 2018 से। तो सबसे पहले हम लोग 2019 में सीएससी के साथ एमओयू किए कि उनके द्वारा हमें जो करंट सिनेरियो चल रहा है उसके संदर्भ में एक सपोर्ट मिलेगा, कैसे कैसे और कैसे क्या करना है। और सीएससी के द्वारा हमारे यहाँ नगर पालिका के जेई और पहले ईओ जो है उनको और विभिन्न एसडीएम डीएम साहब तक के सबको ट्रेनिंग, विभिन्न 17 अलग अलग टॉपिक पे सबको ट्रेनिंग कराई गई है। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज। और मैं बताना चाहूंगा कि जैसे यहाँ इनके द्वारा एक सिटी सैनिटेशन प्लान बनाया गया, इफेक्टिव सेप्टिक मैनेजमेंट को ट्रीटमेंट और सैनिटेशन की सेफ्टी प्लानिंग कैसे हो, हेल्थ एंड सेफ्टी सैनिटेशन वर्कर्स का कैसे क्या हो, और एसएफडी टूल के द्वारा हम लोगों ने अपने यहाँ का फीकल स्लज का एक मेजरमेंट देखा कि शुरुआती में जब हम फीकल स्लज से के कैसे प्रॉपर ट्रीटमेंट और वैज्ञानिक तरीके उससे परिचित नहीं थे, और हमारे शहर का क्या एक अलाइनमेंट है फीकल स्लज का, किस स्तर से वो हम नहीं कर पा रहे हैं और कहाँ तक हमारी चीजें हैं, उस तरीके की चीजें बनाई गई। और ये कुछ फोटोग्राफ्स हैं जहाँ हमारे एक्सपोजर्स और कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग के लिए ट्रेनिंग हुई थी। इसमें दो ट्रेनिंग मैंने भी अटेंड की, उड़ीसा वाली और एक बांग्लादेश में। उड़ीसा में हम लोगों ने भुवनेश्वर में जा करके देखा, अभी तक किताबों में जो देखा था या फिर पढ़ा था, लेकिन वहाँ जाके वहाँ देखा कि वहाँ कोर ट्रीटमेंट कैसे चल रहा था, और बांग्लादेश का शफीपुर मॉडल जा करके देखा था कि वहाँ कैसे को कंपोस्टिंग की जा सकती है। इसके लिए बिजनौर में भी हम लोग प्रयासरत हैं और लैंड और इत्यादि सारी चीजें हो चुकी हैं, सुन जैसे ही होगा हम लोग काम कर लेंगे। इसके लिए हम लोग सिटी में एक सिटी सैनिटेशन टास्क फोर्स बना गया, जिसमें यहाँ के स्टेक होल्डर्स और नगर पालिका के एम्प्लाई और शहर के कुछ ऐसे लोग हैं, जिसके साथ हमारी अभी हाल में ही पांचवी बैठक हुई है COVID-19 को लेकर के और व्हीकल स्लज को लेकर के, दोनों को कैसे कोरिलेट करके हमें आगे बढ़ना है इसके बारे में हमारी चर्चा की। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज। अभी जैसे हम लोग बता रहे हैं कि हमारा ड्राफ्ट बिल्कुल बन चुका है कि हम कैसे काम करेंगे, एफएसएम रूल जो है यूपी गवर्नमेंट से भी जो है उसको देखते हुए, और सिटी और यहाँ के सीएससी के जो कोलिग्स हैं हमारे साथ, उन्होंने बताया है कि कैसे इसको बन गया ड्राफ्ट बिल्कुल फाइनल रूप में, जल्दी इसका इम्प्लीमेंट किया जाएगा। और इसके लिए हम लोग लैंड वगैरह की भी चीजें हमारे पास आ चुकी हैं, जल्द ही सारी कार्य हम लोग कर लेंगे।
थैंक यू, वेरी गुड,
थैंक यू सर।
और ये मैं ये चीज बताना चाहूंगा, ये एसएफडी का एक जो हमारा था जो टूल अभी था कि 2017 में मात्र 3% हम लोग 3% पे जो हम लोग थे, ये मैं चाहूंगा कि एसएफडी का ड्राइंग का दिखा जाए, जिसमें शुरू में मात्र 3% पे थे,
आज हम
47% पेपली मैनेज कर रहे हैं। ये चीज मैं बड़ी ईमानदारी से कहूंगा, बांग्लादेश में गया तो मैं समझा, मुझे नहीं पता था ये एसएफडी है क्या चीज। तो सीएससी का जाने के बाद जैसे हम लोग बिल्कुल सिंपल आर्ट बैकग्राउंड के हैं, ये टेक्निकलिटी समझ में आई, किसी शहर में अगर फर्दर भी मेरी पोस्टिंग होती है तो ये टूल बहुत ही अच्छा है, और आगे मैं भी लोगों को बताने की कोशिश करूं।
थैंक यू सर।
आगे स्लाइड चेंज कर दीजिए।
और ये हमारा कुछ मेसन ट्रेनिंग था और पीपी किट था कि कैसे हम अगर कहीं डिसलज कर रहे हैं और शेड्यूल डिसलज कर रहे हैं। इसमें बताना चाहूंगा कि हमारा कोई रजिस्टर्ड नहीं था, तो हम लोग प्राइवेट डिसलजर को रजिस्टर्ड किए, और हमारे पास खुद मैं अपनी दो मशीनें फंक्शनल कराया हूं, और ताकि कैसे शहर में जो ये एफएसएम को ऐसे किया जा सके। ये COVID-19 को लेकर के जो दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण तरीके से अपने देश और क्या पूरा विश्व सामना कर रहा है, इसके लिए अवेयरनेस हुआ और इसमें सीएससी का काफी सपोर्ट मिला। लगभग 800 पेंटिंग और 150 से ज्यादा स्लोगन और 50 से ज्यादा वॉल राइटिंग और पब्लिक एड्रेस सिस्टम के द्वारा पूरे बिजनौर में इस चीज का अवेयरनेस किया गया और काफी अच्छा इसका प्रभाव रहा जिला प्रशासन से लेकर के अन्य नगर पालिकाएं भी और अन्य संस्थाएं भी इससे काफी प्रेरित हुई। ये हम लोगों का है कि आगे का कैसे प्लान है, तो DPR हम लोगों का ये बन चुका है, सॉरी बाइलाज इसका इम्प्लीमेंटेशन कराना है। और इसके साथ एक बहुत पहले हम लोगों का डिस्कस हुआ था रिवार्ड सिस्टम का कि डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड वेस्ट वाटर, ये भी हमारे नगर पालिका के पार्क में चीजें हैं। जैसे थोड़ा सा COVID-19 की चीजें जैसे जैसे सामान्य हो रही है, कुछ फाइनेंशियल इश्यूज भी हैं, उसके बाद हम इस विषय पे बहुत आगे बढ़ेंगे। थैंक यू।
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
थैंक यू दुर्गेश्वर जी, बहुत अच्छा काम बढ़ रहा है, बट आपके सहयोग के बिना यह संभव नहीं था। बट आई एम हैप्पी कि आप लोगों को काफी अच्छा लगा कि जो आप लोगों ने सीखा वो जमीन तौर पे। त्यागी जी, अ फ्रेंड एंड अ पार्टनर विद हुम वी हैव वर्क्ड, प्लीज फ्रॉम दिल्ली जल बोर्ड।
थैंक यू सुरेश एंड थैंक यू मेरिन for giving me the opportunity to speak about the long association of CSC with Delhi Jal Board and the subsequent achievement in Delhi Jal Board. Good afternoon, everyone, the eminent speakers, jury members, and the participants. It will be a very injustice for me to finish my talk within 5 minutes or 6 minutes for the long association of 15 years with CSC. At least give me 1 minute for 1 year.
आपका एक अलग से वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग करके आप भिजवाइएगा, हम डालेंगे।
थैंक यू सो मच। कैन यू शेयर माय प्रेजेंटेशन, वेरी स्मॉल प्रेजेंटेशन?
यू हैव मेल्ड मी दैट प्रेजेंटेशन?
नो, आई हैव नॉट मेल्ड, इट इज ऑन माय स्क्रीन।
ओके, यू वांट टू
फिर आपको स्क्रीन।
ओके, गॉट इट। ठीक है सर,
तो आपको शेयर करना पड़ेगा।
आप शेयर कर लीजिए सर।
आई एम शेयरिंग, इट इज विजिबल।
Yes.
Yeah. And am I audible?
Yes.
So thank you so much. It is a long association with Delhi Jal Board with CSC. The first I interacted with CSC in 2005 when we were fighting in Supreme Court in the Meli Yamuna case, that was CWP 720/1994. And every department were filing the affidavit alleging Delhi Jal Board responsible for polluting river Yamuna. Then we interacted Madam Sunita Narayan. She gave us very, very good suggestions for us to encounter all those affidavits by giving some concrete proposal before the Supreme Court. So with her advice, we then filed an affidavit encountering the affidavit of the then Secretary, Ministry of Urban Development, who is now the Lieutenant Governor of Delhi. So it was a very challenging job for us, but it was succeeded by submitting the proposal of interceptor sewer along the three major drains and to trap all the drains into the sewerage system for reuniting the river Yamuna. So that was my first interaction with CSC. Was very helpful in giving me the right advice for fighting the case. The second one was the CSC. We all the senior officers of the Delhi Jal Board were very fond of visiting the abroad for in the name of the good and the technical support and the for in the name of capacity building. Of course, it is a routine visit for them, but there was no scope of giving the training or imparting the training to the front-end employees, that is plumbers, the operators, the fitters, and the junior engineers. So they were not having the proper training. Then we approached to CSC in 2000, I remember in 2012. So we approached to Suresh and then he accepted our offer. Then they imparted training to the engineers, junior engineers, plumbers, and the technical workers of the Delhi Jal Board on rainwater harvesting system, on constructing the septic tanks and the small DVAT system, the decentralized wastewater treatment plant. And with the result, and you remember, Mr. Suresh, that I spared my entire day with your training program. I was there during the lunch. I sat on within the plumbers to see the trainings, how it is effective. And the result came, and it was very useful training for the, at least for plumbers and our technical workers, who added their livelihoods by constructing the rainwater harvesting system in the city. They constructed the septic tank on the very technically, in technical manners, and they earned money by after obtaining the training from the CSC. Now the third support that was very a paradigm shift in the Legal Board, the construction of decentralized wastewater treatment plant at Delhi Jal Board headquarters. It is a very beautiful story behind it, that there used to be a sewage overflow in front of the Jhandewala temple. So we found out that why it is happening in the daytime, because then we found out that the sewage and the wastewater from the headquarter, which is operating the daytime, is causing the overflow in the sewage system. So then Mr. Rohila suggested that why don't you set up a decentralized wastewater treatment plant at the headquarter, which will eliminate the sewage overflow, and it will add to the clean water for the horticulture purposes within the premises of the Legal Board. Then we invited the tenders, and then nobody, then you remember, Mr. Suresh, that nobody was daring to come forward to construct this decentralized wastewater treatment plant, because nobody knew that what is the decentralized wastewater treatment plant. Then we conducted a workshop within the Delhi Jal Board headquarters. We called some tender, the expert contractors. Then we made to learn them that it is very simple structure. It is like a septic tank followed by the filtration media and growing some vegetation over it. Then they came forward and then they constructed the decentralized wastewater treatment plant of 35 KLD at Delhi Jal Board headquarters. And ultimately, we were drawing the water from the two wells. There were two two wells dedicated for horticulture purposes, which were eliminated thereafter after operating this decentralized sewage treatment plant.
Ab to policy bana diye Delhi government ne, sir.
No. Then I will remind you one more story. Then we conducted a seminar in India Habitat Center on sanitation and the rejuvenation of water bodies and river Yamuna. Then you raised a question that why Delhi Jal Board is not owning the water bodies, and I objected it to, because it is not our mandate. And then you reminded me that these water bodies are the source of raw water, and due to the sewage water coming to the water bodies and filling the wastewater, it is polluting the groundwater, which is another source of Delhi Jal Board for drinking water. Then when I took over as a member water in September 2013, yes. My first task was to place the proposal before the board for adopting all the water bodies in Delhi by the Delhi Jal Board. Very, and then Delhi Jal Board, after a struggle of 3 years, we succeeded in adopting 255 water bodies for rejuvenation, which has been taken up. And it is very interesting to know that your model of decentralized wastewater treatment plant is being adopted at all the water bodies and the parks for cleaning of the wastewater which is coming from the surrounding area, and it is feeding the water bodies as a clear water. Yes. So it is a source of water for replenishing the groundwater also. And you contributed in finalization of the water policy for Delhi. In 2012, we formulated the water policy, and then we debated a lot, and we held a workshop under the chairmanship of Mr. Arvind Kejriwal, Chief Minister. You were the convener of the and of course you annoyed the CM also at that time by raising some valid questions which were not replied by him. And by the way, then you contributed a lot in formulation of the water policy, which is still on the table of the current chief minister, and he has not finalized so far.
He made a policy on decentralized wastewater management.
But he has made the policy of decentralized wastewater treatment plant, and at all the water bodies and at all the decentralized plant, we are adopting this decentralized wastewater treatment plant as we have set up in the headquarter. Another wastewater treatment plant on the same technology is being constructed at Jal Vihar under your guidance and the technical support, and it is going to be, I think, finalized within a month or so. Because of the COVID-19, it got delayed because labor was not there. And recently, you have given a very contributed in formulating the septage management regulation 2018, which has been passed by the cabinet of Delhi. DJV mainstream the fecal sludge management and giving the license to the desludgers who were vendors of the who are working in the unauthorized colonies, and they were discharging the septage into the existing water bodies and the drains, thus polluting them. Now with the formulation of this regulation with the help of CSC, now they are being regulated, and now they are discharging their septage, which has been dislodged from the septic tanks from the sewered areas, into the designated place where the fecal sludge treatment plant is there, or it is being discharged to the respective sewage treatment plant. So it is a very important contribution given by CSC to the Delhi Jal Board. This is the line diagram of the pilot project which has been constructed at Delhi Jal Board headquarters of 35 MLD. This is nothing but a septic tank or the sedimentation tank where the 60-70% biological load is reduced, and thereafter the effluent is passed through the filter media, and the root zones of the some species like Allopheris, Polyrhesus, Softam, Borus.
Provide the details of the presentation.
So there are so many. Yeah, of course. So this is being, and then you will surprise to note that the results of the treated effluent are means it is more than the standard. This is of the tertiary quality. And it was surprised to know that the labor were washing their mouth with this treated effluent, and then we had to force them not to use this for their washing their hand and etc.
Thank you. Happy to hear.
And then thereafter, I'm concluding that the advantage of this long association was that it was a one-time investment on the capital cost. There is hardly operation maintenance cost on this plant, and this is being used for the horticulture purpose and the washing purposes also. And two tuels, as I already mentioned, that this has been eliminated. The recurring expenditure has been eliminated, and this model is being replicated in all other Delhi, and there are 10 projects are in hand with Delhi Jal Board for this.
Thank you very much, Tyagiji. I should also admit it would not have been possible without support of you and that time CEO.
That's right.
And the South Africa, South Asia country people visit this place, and we are very happy to see that now the government has a policy. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
We have a last presentation. I know I'm extremely sorry for running too late and eating on to lunch hour. We'll have 5 minutes from last presentation, ASCII presentation, I think.
Yeah, it's an oral presentation by Joshna.
And we will close it in 5 minutes. Yeah, please.
I won't take much time. So firstly, thank you for the invitation, and apologies, I don't have a formal PPT to present. So get started. So before I explain in detail about the impact of CSC training on implementation, I would like to just start by giving a brief introduction to the programs that we run in ASCII, especially in the sector of FSSM. So ASCII supports Government of Telangana and City of Warangal as a technical and knowledge partner in achieving safe sanitation. So Warangal City is one of the sewage cities, and it is being completely dependent on on-site sanitation. And it is one of the first cities to have implemented the FSM guidelines and regulations. So And these guidelines has not only just helped in shaping the Telangana policy, but also the national policy. So ASCII, with the help of a city government and the BMGF, has set up a fecal sludge treatment plan to treat these sludge coming from the on-site sanitation systems. And it is one of the first plans to be installed in our country. And right now, the city is also working towards addressing the needs of women, vulnerable groups, and urban poor, and working towards achieving the CY's principles. So these experiences of Warangal had led the state to recognize the need for implementing FSSM across the state, and the state has taken a decision to develop 71 FSTPs in all of its ULBs through public-private partnership. And similar exercises were also carried out in AP with the innovations from the city of Narsapur. So just briefing all this, so in all these interventions, having the right kind of human capital within ASCII is very important, and CSE has helped us in building these human capitals, and the course offered by the CSE were of immense benefit for us in learning the tools and techniques and also knowing the good practices across the globe. So for instance, some of our colleagues has participated in the sheet flow diagram workshop, where we have learned about the creation and also how to use this tool for decision making with the bureaucrats. So leading this workshop, we had prepared the SFD reports for all the towns, that is for 71 towns in Telangana and 106 towns in AP, and this had actually helped us in having a sanitation advocacy with the bureaucrats at the state level. And also these reports has reinforced the need for having FSSM regulations in the state, and also to have FSTPs in all the states of AP and Telangana. So I'd like to thank CSE for providing such capacity building trainings, and I'd like to end by saying that these refresher courses that CSE offered is of greater value for implementing the programs that we do at ASCII. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Jyotsna. That was very, very crisp and sound and pointed presentation.
Yeah, I made it very brief in the interest of time.
Oh, very good. Yeah. So, but I should appreciate everybody and apologize you for half an hour delay. And I would like to now formally open up as a moderator for 5 minutes just to ask if anybody has any questions, though we have been asking people to write in the queries or something, query box, or chat box. So, and I have seen speakers also responding to that. I have jury members also, if they have any questions, who would be deciding upon which was the highest outcome in terms of approach. So, Rajneesh, do you have any take? And any participants, please raise your hand and we would be able to take questions.
See, at this stage, there's no question as such, because I think a lot of people has given a very good summary about, and I think in case we'll be deciding who's better and all, we have to take help from your team, because they are the one who has been working extensively with them. And I can see that their last three projects, which were like almost where I can find reflection of CSE in every place. Yeah. Like these, the projects of Jal Board. In fact, I also learned from the same examples of Jal Board while I entered into CSE. So there are a lot of relationships which we need to recheck with your team and then start finally give marks.
Actually, every story is so beautiful and so learning experience for even us. Like, we don't know when we do training. So Suparno, are you still around? Or Aditya? Is Suparno around? Okay, but Suparno had to go. And he had internet problem also. So I do know that. So any of the participant has any question? I am ready to take, because you have been very patient listening for 3 hours. Any participant has any question? You can unmute yourself, or can the hosts unmute all the participants if they or somebody who raises hand. So, if not, then I would like to take this opportunity to say that we would be taking up all the questions and taking them to the speakers and responding them and putting on the website whatever the questions were there and the answers to that. We will be putting up all the presentations on the web. We have also a recording of this webinar, which we have done. So we would be sharing a copy to all participants. And I would like to thank each and every participant and the speaker who has taken time out. And we would like to remain in touch with you. And we would be organizing series of such impact stories. And we would develop a website, a web page. It is actually there for sanitation, which is called Mount. We will also do it for water in the coming months. and where we can put together this alumni web portal where we can learn from each other. We can have regular discussion forum, but annually we could have an event where we could come together and we can review that whatever you share, that there are some projects in the process, how do we move, and we can document these things. So what gets monitored, is measured, is also the impact. So you would see over here, we had alumni for last 1 or 2 years. We have also partnerships for 10 years. Each and every story was important, useful. I would say good learning for me and my team. I would like to thank all the team members, Mehreen, Shivali, who coordinated this meeting, all other team members, and all Rajneesh, Suparno, Aditya, who spared time from the busy schedules to be with us. And thank you very much to all. Stay healthy, stay safe, take care. And one-to-one, you can reach out to me. You can drop email to me, phone me, and we will be in touch with all of you. Thank you very much, all of you.
There is one participant who has raised his hand.
Maybe if it's to a person, you want to unmute it? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Hi, sir. Bakshi this side. So I also would, you know, I just wanted to thank you for all the, I mean, trainings. I've always been an individual participant for the trainings which CSE has organized, not on behalf of any organization, but I participated always individually. And it has been a true joy every time whenever I participate. I've also had short interactions with you during, if you might be remembering, the urban sanitation workshop at the Priya. Which Priya had organized. Yes. So it has been a true joy to attend all these trainings. I first training which I attended was with Bitush sir in 2017 when FSM program was launched in August to December 2017, where got to know about, I mean, that time I was studying at Tata Institute, so got to know about shit flow diagrams for the first time. So
Every word is very important. It is pearl of wisdom for us because we keep on doing one training after that, second training, going to another city, another country. Every story is so overwhelming and encouraging. I should say thank you very much, all of you. Thank you, please. So you want to say further last word? And I just concluded because we are actually running behind you.
Yes, I understand. No, you said the last words, and your words matter a lot since you've been working in this sphere for many decades now.
We would like to remain in touch with all of you people, and please keep on coming back to us with more stories, more impactful stories, and we would like to invest more into that and work with you. It's an investment for future. Thank you very much, all. I'll officially close this meeting. Mehreen, thank you very much for putting this together. Shivali, thank you very much. Bitush, Rahul, all my program managers, Praveen, and all team members who have put this together. Training is an investment not only from our side, it is investment by your nominating agency or departments, and we wanted this to be captured, and we will, once we upload this link, we will share it with all the agencies, all the institutional partners. They can also see that what they've invested into. Thank you very much.